Oh, shalom. Again, okay, here's from the Christian Science Monitor about this solar eclipse 2012. They say that all systems are go for witnessing a rare, what they call, ring of fire. Now, this is a so-called phenomenal solar eclipse. Now, notice this right here, up here, right? Notice this up here where it's talking about, these are some of the new news stories. It's talking about the Facebook thing, so forth and so on. Facebook stumbles, Afghanistan. But we just saw where it talked about the euro. Remember, that's one of the signs on Earth right there. Now they say why historic space mission, you know, is having difficulties. The G8, remember the eight heads of the beast, the seventh and the eighth. Anyway, we'll get into that as well. But here on the Christian Science Monitor, they say that the solar eclipse 2012, that all systems are go, right, for witnessing. Now, right here, what you're seeing right here is called the sun is partially blocked by the moon through the ceilings of ancient buildings during a solar eclipse in central China. In central China, these are being witnessed all over the world, right? Now, you see there's a solar eclipse witnessed through some of the ancient buildings in China, through the ceiling of some ancient buildings in China. Very, very interesting right there, right? So something similar like that is to be seen in this solar eclipse, you know, witnessing of a rare ring of fire. Remember, there's a ring of fire on Earth. You understand, these earthquakes that's been going on, there's also a ring of fire on Earth. And they say when this ring of fire busts out, whoa, yo, great tribulation. So there's a rare annular eclipse, right, where a ring of fire, it outlines the moon as it crosses the sun, and it will greet United States viewers, those who view, especially on the west coast of the United States, Sunday evening. Right, Sunday evening, right? So residents of the U.S. West will have a good shot at seeing the full ring, the full fire ring, fire. So now this is from the 19th, May 19th, 2012. Now on a kind of a personal level, you know, my earthly past about 3 years ago to this very day just brought to my attention. So I just find that I'm going to name it and claim it. This will be the anniversary of my earthly father's passing, you know, on the 20th, 3 years ago, right? And when it was brought to my attention and I put the two together, I said, wow, how interesting. So I just named that and claim that right there. It's a definite sign for more reasons than just that. But even on that particular level, I noticed that it's very, very interesting. So right here, there's some more on this Christian Science page right here, the annular solar eclipse in India. A chanting temple goes silent. In other words, in this temple right here where they be chanting, they go silent. I mean, it just shut them down right there. So the solar eclipse will be visible from 154 nations. You see that right there? 154 nations will be able to witness this particular solar eclipse that is to come about on Sunday. Now they have some distraction stuff over here, you know, some distraction stuff, all the idolatry, all the nonsense, the whitewashing, white supremacy right there, the confusion, following, living in the image of the beast, you know. But let's go up here and let's look at this a little bit more. Now, what does this article says? This article says that the last time that an annular solar eclipse hovered above Los Angeles in 1992, they call it a dumb cloud. Bring that up right there. They call it what? A dumb cloud. You understand? As one young stargazer said at the time, it ruined the show. some so-called dumb cloud ruined the show. In other words, a cloud covered it up in 1992 on Sunday. Angelenos, maybe that's Los Angeles folks, that's what they call themselves, they will get another, hopefully much better shot at witnessing at least part of a phenomena. So we talked about this as a phenomena where the face of the moon can't quite block the sun, creating either a partial or a complete halo in the sky, right? Aside from some localized fog and cloud banks, the weather forecasters are calling for mostly clear skies for a paintbrush stroke of the U.S. that runs from Oregon to northern Texas, where locals will be able to see the full ring of fire as it appears on the U.S. continental shelf for the first time in nearly what? And nearly 20 years, that's half of that 40-year prophetic period, right? Los Angeles is slightly south of the zone, meaning residents will instead see a what? A crescent sun, not a crescent moon, but a crescent sun, which is nothing to sneeze at either, whatever that means. But it says right now, it appears the majority of the territory, the majority of the territory in the zone of the annular eclipse, not annual, but the annular eclipse, will be in good shape with two possible exceptions, writes the Weather Channel's Chris Dolce, the tail end, quote, the tail end of a frontal boundary and an upslope wind flow could bring some isolated thunderstorms and cloud cover to Eastern New Mexico and Western Texas. Elsewhere, an approaching frontal system off the northwest coast is likely to bring extensive cloud cover to southwest Oregon and far northwest California. Hundreds of national parks and astronomy enthusiasts are planning viewing parties across the region, with Texas authorities suggesting those who want to see the full effect head to the northern part of the state, like Lubbock or even up to Albuquerque in New Mexico. Hail up to I and I Peoples, the Church of Rastafari in New Mexico, and the brothers and sisters over there, where the viewing is likely to be prime, right? Some of the best specific places to witness the eclipse include Utah's Zion, notice that right there, Zion National Park. What a name. California's Lake Tahoe region, Arizona's Grand Canyon, and the Pueblos of northern New Mexico. In parentheses, remember, don't look at the sun directly through anything less than number 14 arc welder's glasses. Use projection devices instead, such as a hole pricked in a sheet of primer paper. Keep that in mind, brothers and sisters. Don't want to go blind looking at this phenomenal event that's coming up. All right? Mm-hmm. Okay, let's just go on, complete this article right here, and we'll move on to the prophetic content of this. Now, Californians, for their part, right, are being cautioned that inland areas may be better than beaches for watching the eclipse, since the regular gray clouds that roll in from the Pacific in the evening can arrive as early as 5 p.m., deep ending on location, the eclipse will begin around 5:24 p.m. local time in California, peak at 6:38, with the full sun revealed again at 7:42 p.m., a few minutes before sunset. Sunday's rare annular eclipse is part of what's become an astronomically active spring. Get that, an astronomically active spring. So there's a lot of heavenly signs and activities. So you might not recognize the prophecy on earth, but you can see it in the heavens. And Yeshua HaMashiach, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, said there would be days like these. So this is an astronomically active spring in the U.S. where excited sky watchers have in recent weeks borne witness to meteor showers and a, quote, supermoon. A supermoon. Remember, we touched briefly on the supermoon. The next major solar eclipse in the U.S. won't come until, what it says, August 21st, 2017, which is a part of this whole period that we're about to go into, you know, which biblically is called the Day of the Lord. Not just a day, all right, but a period of time. Some say a year. We say possibly up to 7 or so years between this 2012 and 2020. Because remember, 2020 is good vision, right? So the vision is being fulfilled. Now, although Australia and parts of South Pacific will see one later this year on November 17th. So another one coming up on November 17th. Now, some related stories down here we thought were interesting. Annular solar eclipse in India, a chanting temple goes silent. Hush, shifinfin. In China, a thoroughly modern view of annular solar eclipse. And solar eclipse down here, right, visible from 154 national parks Sunday. Did they say national parks up here, or did they say, okay, national parks? I said nations, all right? But there's many nations that will be able to see it. The only ones that won't see this coming up are those of us so-called over here on the East Coast. You understand? But there are also signs that we should be aware of that we can see over here to recognize just what the signs of the times are. So this solar eclipse 2012, all systems go for witnessing rare ring of fire event. So do a little bit of Google on this. If you check out a little bit of the Google on this, you'll see that there are other links to this particular event. So either it will look something like that or like that, you know, the crescent, so forth and so on. And more to come. Stay tuned, brothers and sisters. And of course, watch and pray. Shalom, Rastafari.